Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and we've got a Photoshop tutorial today all about the extract filter. So this image was taken in my studio with the idea that I would cut him out from the background and add in a better background later on. Now, to cut things out, you've got a whole different options inside of Photoshop, and if I asked you what one you'd choose, what tool you'd choose, I bet you'd probably go with the magic wand, and it's a good choice because it kind of works really well. Trouble with the magic wand is it's not so good around areas of fine detail like hair. In fact, it makes a real mess of hair. So for this instance, magic wand isn't the tool of choice. That's where the extract filter comes into its own. Go to filter and choose extract. Now, this big filter is fairly easy to get your head around once you've mastered the basics. What you need to do is to draw around the object you wish to extract, and then fill it using the fill tool. Okay, let's start with the first bit. We'll draw around the edges. To be honest, I find it much easier to zoom in nice and close so you can really see what you're doing. And the other thing I find much easier is to ignore the standard brush size and make it just a little bit bigger. Sort of 60 to 70 pixels works for me. And then all you need to do is just draw with the green highlighter pen. And that's going to show Photoshop where your edges are and make an extraction based upon that. But if you've got a high contrast, like we have between his red jacket and the blue background, there's a little button here on the tool options that says Smart Highlighting. Now this is great because this works in a slightly different way. It tries to find the edges for you and it'll give a nice thin line. Basically, with the extract tool, the thinner the line you can draw, the better that your extraction will look. But it is very hard to do this with a thin line on areas when you're trying to do it manually. But using the smart highlighting, it's actually quite easy. That is until you get to areas where it's not so clearly defined, and then things go slightly wrong. So down the trousers, for example, it's a lot harder because we have the contrast fine here, but the blue jeans and the blue background, there's very little between them, and Photoshop has a bit of trouble with that. So in those sort of areas, switch off smart highlighting and just do it manually. Now, you will need to do some cleaning up afterwards, but I'll show you how to do that at the end. Let's do the other side of his trousers, like so, and then we'll switch back to smart highlighting, and off we go. And around, and the smart highlighting tool follows the edges really, really neatly indeed. Like that, all the way up the side. And you can go much quicker with this tool. Just don't make any mistakes, missed a bit there. Try and get it, there we go, got it this time. And around we go. Whoops, that's Control Z to undo. Now, with the undo, there's something worth noting here. You only get to go backwards one step. So if you make lots of mistakes, you may be in trouble and you might have to start again. But if you just be a little bit careful and just remember, only backwards one step, then things aren't so bad. Try and get that neck a little bit clearer. That's it. Now, the last bit, the bit I've left to last, is probably the most important bit. That's the actual hair area itself. Now, this smart highlighting is very good, except on areas where you probably really, really want it, like on the hair. Just go around this side of the ear as well. So when it comes to hair, I'm afraid smart highlighting isn't going to do it, and I've got to switch that off and get a small brush. Let's go in really small, back down to 30 or 20 even, and zoom right in and try and paint these hairs in a little bit more manually. Now, you don't have to be anything artistic here. We're not looking for high quality. Just make sure they're kind of covered like that. Again, the smaller you can make your highlighting tool, the better your extraction will look. So we'll just pick out as many of these little hairs as we can, like that, and nearly there. And then down the side of his head where it's a few down there too. Lovely. Okay, so there we are. We've drawn all the way around him. One bit I missed, down here, between his trousers. If you've got any internal areas you need to cut out, don't forget to draw around those as well, because otherwise your background will stay inside of those areas, but we wanted to get rid of that. And we're now ready to use the fill tool, which is this sort of paint bucket tool, and just click anywhere inside your highlighted area. Now, what should happen is that your item you wish to extract, the bloke in this case, becomes coloured. But if your whole image becomes coloured, you've got a small hole somewhere on your highlighter. And it's so easy to do that, especially using the smart highlighting. So zoom in close, have a good look round, find the hole, and then fill it in with the highlighter tool. So once you've got to this stage, click the preview button and you should get an idea of how your extract is going to look. Just takes a few seconds to do that. There we go. And we can zoom in nice and close. Let's go to the hair, the bit we're really interested in. Okay, that's looking pretty good. It's got a few areas here where it's not so good. There's a few bits down the side of his head where it hasn't worked quite so well, but by and large, it's done quite a good job. Right, let's see if we can tidy up some of these parts where it doesn't work quite so well. Let's go up to his hair first of all, and we'll do that. To tidy things up, I'm going to use the tool down here, the cleanup tool. And a bit smaller brush size. There we go, 11, that'll do nicely. And we'll just clean these areas up like so. There you go, lovely, that's done. And then we'll move down the side of his head until we get to his ear. Now, if I use it here where it's missed a little tiny bit, it'll actually take it away. That's what this tool does. So if I hold the Alt button, the ALT, it does reverse. It puts it back in. We can just go around the edge of his ear there and under his chin, like so. Let's just pump the brush size back up to about 30 again, just to work a bit quicker. And I can work my way around the image, holding Alt to bring the image back through where it's made too much of a selection. And not holding Alt if I want to remove any of the blue. But as we go down the side of his arm, then things are looking pretty good there. So I think we'll just do that bit there. Now, the trouser area, a little bit more tricky, but it's not a problem. You can bring it back using the cleanup tool. I'll just go down the parts here. You can see the selection was a lot worse where we used the thicker brush. So this is the importance of using a thinner brush to really get a neat, clean edge. And just a little bit around here as well. And yeah, now this side's looking even worse still. So again, holding the Alt with the cleanup brush will bring the detail back through. And it kind of fades it in. It doesn't just return it. It brings it back in looking for the edge. It's rather clever. Like so. Which is lucky, really, because this could be quite tricky. But this tool really does make it a much faster job. Like that, there we go. There's a bit there where it shouldn't be, so we'll take that away. Lovely. And then up the other side, just make sure it's all up okay around his arms. A little bit there that's gone missing, so we'll bring that back in. And a bit around the edge of his hood as well, so we'll bring that in too. There we go. And a bit around the top of the ear, just when you think you've finished. Smashing. There you go, so that's it, we're done. So we've now cut him out. We can click OK. And there we are. It's now done that inside of Photoshop. So there's how you make a really clean extraction. And it really does work rather well. And all you need to do now is just add in a new background. And we'll just drag him onto his new background. Here we go. We'll use the Move tool. Drag him over. And there he is. Wonderful. So there we are. That's how you use the extraction tool.